All right, here's a problem for you. You come in at 8 o'clock in the morning, and you're going to dump a certain amount of cells into a flask. By 11 o'clock, you measured those cells, and it comes out to about 3,850 cells, to be fairly exact. You come back later that day, and by 5 o'clock, you notice the cells have grown quite quickly. You look under the scope and notice there's about 36,530 cells. So you counted pretty accurately. That's good. Your question now comes up as to what was the initial stock concentration of cells at 8 o'clock in the morning when you dumped them into the flask, and two, what's the cell growth rate, or in this case, K. And what I mean by K is that most cells are going to follow the relationship of C, or concentration, is equal to initial concentration times the exponential, is the growth rate constant, K, times time. That's a pretty simple equation that you've probably seen before and will continue to see in the future, and does, for the most part, model population growth, cell growth, etc. So, now without going to a computer and using some kind of nice analytical software and plugging in these values and determining all that for you, there's a simpler way to do this and something you need to practice, and that's what is known as linearization. So the question is, if you were to linearize this non-linear equation into a linear form, what would that be? Hopefully you're right, and you would get the following. Natural log of C is equal to natural log of C naught plus KT. Now the question is this linear? Well, the definition of a linear equation is something that follows the form Y equals MX plus B, where Y is our dependent variable, B is our intercept, and X is our independent variable. So we do see that this follows the linear form Y equals MX plus B. And to determine the slope of any linear line, it's just going to be y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And in this case, we're going to take the natural log, the concentration at times 2, and subtract the concentration at time 1, and that's going to be over time 2 minus time 1. And we do the natural logs because that's how we're plotting that form of the equation. That natural log of C takes on our y. So if we plug this in, we're going to get the following, and we have the times of 9 and 3 hours based on our start time of 8 o'clock and the two time points that we collected. And this should yield a K of 0.375 hours to the minus 1, since the top part of that slope doesn't have units, but the bottom part does. So now we found our K. So once we know the slope, we just go ahead and plug that back in our equation and solve for the natural log of C naught. So I'll choose the first point, natural log of 3,850, and that's going to be the natural log of C naught plus 0.375 hours to the minus 1 times the time, which in this case is 3 hours. Doing this solves for C naught equaling 1,250 cells. So now the question is, if you had to come in the lab and split your cells once they reach, say, 2 million, at what time would you have to run back in the lab to do this? So when is the population of cells going to be 2 million? Well, we could go back to our initial linear equation. We could either use the information there, or now that we have C naught and K, we could go ahead and use the main equation and solve for a T. And so in this case, if we want 2 million cells, that's going to equal 1,250 e to the 0.375 times t. And if you solve this equation for t, you should see that t comes out to about 19.7 hours. So this is bad news for you, because if you started this at 8 a.m. and you had to come back in 19.7 hours later, you're going to be at lab around 4 a.m. Something to consider when you're planning your experiments in the future, but hopefully at least this example has given you an idea why linearization is an important tool that can help you do some pretty simple, quick calculations.